Acelero. पेज
ठीक है
पर
सर,
कंप्यूटर
इम्तियाज भाई फैसल भाई थोड़ा चैट सेशन को कंफर्म करें, अब चैट आ रहा है राइट?
नहीं है
जी, आ रहा चैट आ रहा है।
ओके, और डॉक्टर साहब का वीडियो नजर आ रहा है आप लोग को?
अभी वीडियो तो नहीं नजर आ रहा।
ठीक है, मुझे भी नहीं नजर आ रहा, एक मिनट देखो।
मैंने
अब
बात
आ,
ओके
जी
पेज फोर पॉइंटर सी नहीं है, इसको अभी लोड कर सकते हैं आप।
तो मुझे लगता है लाइव कर लीजिए, जब तक ज्वाइन करेंगे उन आप अनाउंस कर दीजिएगा कि ज्वाइन कर लें और लाइव आ रहे हैं वो डॉक्टर साहब।
वालेकुम अस्सलाम वरहमतुल्लाहि वबरकातुहू। एक मिनट, हरुण भाई अस्सलाम वालेकुम वरहमतुल्लाहि वबरकातुहू।
सलाम वरहमतुल्लाह, कैसे जी?
जी सर, अल्लाह का करम, अल्हम्दुलिल्लाह। मैं ही कॉल किया था सर आपको, एंड आई बिलीव यू आर कॉलिंग मी बैक, सो जजाक अल्लाह फॉर ज्वाइनिंग। मैंने आपको को होस्ट भी बना दिया है।
सही है।
चलिए सर, आई तो एज एडवाइज बाय डॉक्टर साहब, वी आर गोइंग टू हैव द फर्स्ट सेशन ऑफ डॉक्टर साहब, राइट?
या
चलिए सर, तो आई विल गो फॉर लाइव नाउ। डॉक्टर साहब इजाजत है लाइव करने की? तो
बिल्कुल है।
आई रिक्वेस्ट ऑल द पार्टिसिपेंट्स, यानी कि ऑल द टीम मेंबर्स, टू अनम्यूट द माइक, म्यूट कर ले अपने माइक को। यस, बिस्मिल्लाह। السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. I hope my voice is clear and audible. Will you please let us know in the chat session that the voice is clear? السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Right, جزاك الله خير. جزاك الله خير. Thank you so much for joining us today. We'll move forward with our session. I request all the participants and the students to recite the dua. Rabbi shrah li sadri wa yassir li amri wa hlul 'uqdatam min lisani yafqahu qawli. I request Dr. Saab to please take the charge, and I'll just hand over to you. Dr. Saab, please go ahead.
Okay. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. Brothers and sisters, welcome back again after Eid. Eid Mubarak to you after a long break, maybe after a long gap, but I hope you have enjoyed the Eid and the break, and Alhamdulillah, let us go back. And in fact, I had sent a message to whoever I could reach to that Arafah was the day when the Quran was completed. And once a Jew, and it's reported in the traditions that once a Jew turned, you know, said to Umar radiallahu anhu that if you know, when he heard this ayah, Al-Yawma akmaltu lakum dinakum wa atmamtu alaykum ni'mati, today I have, you know, akmaltu lakum dinakum, I have perfected your religion, wa atmamtu alaykum ni'mati, and I have completed my favors. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that the deen is complete and perfected. Then this Jew told Umar that if it had been revealed in our religion, then we would have made that day a day of celebration. And Umar said, well, I know that it was revealed on the day of Arafah, so it was a celebration in a way of the completion of the Quran also. So our Eid al-Fitr is related with the Quran, Eid al-Adha is related with the Quran, but unfortunately, and Ramadan is related with the Quran, Tarawih is related with the Quran, Fajr and Maghrib and Aisha is related with the Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has done everything to ensure that Quran is, you know, penetrating into our lives daily, monthly, yearly, And we Muslims have skipped from all those and kept Quran as a paria book or a book which we don't understand. This is the most craziest and the very, very ugly and strange behavior of Muslims, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made sure that Quran is there in every part of our life, and we kind of made sure that we don't understand any word of it. Astaghfirullah, that's how our culturally we have been trained. But congratulations to all of you, mashallah, that you're coming, and may Allah accept our efforts, make us sincere that we are trying to get attached to the Quran. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us with the knowledge of the Quran. Rabbana zidna ilma. So let us continue with pointer 4C.
Doctor, sorry to interrupt. Can you please put mic a bit closer, because the comments are coming, the voice is coming very low.
Voice is low. Huh?
Yeah, yes, please. The mic.
Let me just see. Let me just change the mic, maybe. Which mic is this one? Microphone is in. Is it better now? I just moved myself.
I request the participants, can you please just ping in the WhatsApp, ping in the chat session? Is it
better now? Is it better?
Still the same. Okay.
Or shall I move to one more mic? And I have another mic, which is more professional, but a little bit far. So let me just make it closer. Yeah. So let me ask you. Because also when I was teaching, there was complaint. Okay, now is it better now? Is it better?
Yeah, for us it's okay, and I would like to hear from the students as well.
Let me, I should see in the chat. Yes, okay, the voice is better. Oh no, very low. Okay, let me check one more option. Sorry. Is it better? It's better now, better than before. Okay, fine. And let me just see if I can do a better gain. Okay. If I keep it like this, I mean, does it, no change, huh? Does it now sound better when the mic is so close to me? Or the mic doesn't have any effect?
No, okay, it's so better, Roxa. But
those people who say there is no change, it means it's fine but odd. Yeah, it will be fine but odd. All right, so maybe you have to increase the sound of your speakers. All right, so let us continue. And let's continue. Okay, let me just see, test speaker in my phone.
No, it's better, Doctor. You can continue because.
Microphone. Okay, now how about this one? This must be very, very good.
It's crystal clear, yeah.
I hope this must be much better than before.
Yeah, you're right. It's
yes,
crystal clear.
Okay, great. Very good. Jazakallah khair. So hopefully next time we will not have any complaint. No, my selection was wrong, actually. I was selecting on the speaker side instead of mic side. Auzubillah. All right. So now we are back to the lesson. We are in the first five pages in this second course, in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about hidayah. It starts with Surah Al-Fatiha, where we ask for hidayah, and that is, this hidayah will be given to muttaqin, not for kafirin or munafiqin. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about da'wah of the Quran. And the pointers are, I hope, you know, if you spend some time, you can memorize all of them, prayer and praise and prayer, prayer for guidance and guidance for muttaqin, not for kafirin, not for munafiqin, because they are corrupt and double-faced. First example of fire, second example of rain. And I'm not watching, I'm just saying it from my brain. And Quran's da'wah, invitation of the Quran, Quran's call, Quran's challenge. And then we have on the fourth page, Then we have Quran's warning, Quran's examples, and who will get misguided from the Quran and how can you disbelieve. So we are on the fourth page. Okay. Quran's warning, Quran's examples, and then who goes astray from the Quran, who gets lost. And this is where we are. Third pointer. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the previous verse, وَمَا يُضِلُّ بِهِ إِلَّا الْفَاسِقِينَ. Allah said that the fasiqeen will not get guidance from the Quran. Now he describes their attributes. So the criteria is, oh, some people say, those ignorant, I don't want to even address them too much. But they say, you know, in our culture, oh, if you study the Quran, you will be misguided because you have to study it under scholars and this and that. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said it, who will get guided and who will get misguided. If someone is fasiq, he will get misguided. And how can it be that somebody studies the Quran and gets misguided when people are studying the Quran and becoming Muslims? Allah sent this Quran for hidayah. How can it be a book of misguidance? Astaghfirullah. I don't know what these people will answer in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Anyway, the one we are studying is verse number 7 in the third pointer. And Allah says, Fasiqeen will not get guidance. Fasiqeen will not get guidance from the Quran because they break the covenant of Allah, they break the relationships, and they spread corruption on the earth. These are the three attributes of those who get misguidance. Okay. All right. Now, we will go to the verse and take word by word meanings. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. الذين ينقضون عهد الله من بعد ميثاقه. الذين those who, you know that. ينقضون break. ينقضون break. عهد الله, the covenant of Allah. So you can remember from عهد الله ينقضون will be break because we're talking of fasiqeen. So in the context, you can remember the meanings also. مِن بَعْدِ مِثَاقِهِ, after contracting it. After contracting it. And some other translators said after making it strong. After strengthening it. After contracting it, they break the bond of Allah. The second feature is وَيَقْطَعُونَ, and they cut asunder, they break apart. قَطَع is to cut, okay? Ma amara Allah. Ma means what? Amara, ordered. Amr bil ma'roof, ordering what is good. So amara means he ordered. Ma amara Allah. Allah has ordered. Bihi, it. What Allah has ordered it? An yusala, to be joined. An yusala, to be joined. Wasl is to join. Okay. Wasl is to join. Wasala, he joined. An yusala, to be joined. Wa yufsiduna, and cause corruption fil ard, in the earth. This is the second attribute. So first attribute of fasiq is they break the covenant of Allah. Second is they cut the relations. And the third is wa yufsiduna fil ard. Third is also mentioned, they cause corruption on the earth. Ulaika humul khasirun, those are the losers. Innal insana lafi khusr. So we already know khusr. So khasir, khasira, yakhsaru. Khasir means the one who is losing, and khasirun are losers. All right. So what is that? Yanquduna ahd Allah. Allah's ahd is the standing command to mankind to submit to him, to obey him, and to worship him alone. Min ba'di mithaqi, mithaq or ratification, refers to the agreement of mankind at the time of creation of Adam alayhi salam that they will worship Allah. Note that Allah brought the spirits, the ruh of all of us in front of him and took this covenant. And we all said, oh Allah, you are our Rabb, we will worship you, kind of. So whenever a person realizes, when he feels, when his inner voice says that Quran and Hadith are true and its message is the call of his soul, his heart and his soul, it is the effect of that covenant. Rejecting the truth after realizing is breaking the covenant of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Of course, Allah did not keep it, you know, fresh in our minds, otherwise the test will be over. But when we will be brought back to life after we die, Allah will kind of remind us, these were the times you remembered and you knew that this is the truth and you still rejected it, and so on for those who were fasiqs. In addition to breaking the covenant of Allah, they, that is the fasiq, don't even bother to maintain family relations which help them grow in a healthy environment. So we should maintain our relationships so that we get guided and be successful and not become losers. I'm trying to adjust this my place. Okay. When a person doesn't care about Allah or human beings or even those closest to him, then his talk and his actions will lead only to corruption in the earth through the sins. وَيُفْسِدُونَ فِي الْأَرْضِ. So when you don't bother about covenant of Allah or the orders of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it will lead to corrections. So fasiq people are losers because they lose the true peace of mind and heart, the true love of relatives and other human beings, and most importantly, they lose the eternal happiness. So they are ulaika humul khasirun. In what sense are they khasirun? Not only in the hereafter, but also in this world. Okay. So these are the messages. So can you translate once again? Alladhina, those who yanquduna, break ahdallah, the covenant of Allah, min ba'di mithaqihi, after contracting it, wa yaqta'una, and cut asunder, ma, what, amarallahu, Allah has ordered, bihi, it, an yusala, to be joined. I request all of you to translate, wa yufsiduna, and cause corruption, fil ard, on earth. Okay, we don't say in English in the earth. So in English we say on the earth, but it doesn't mean fi means on. Okay, it depends on culture and the language, the use of language. So fil ard, fi means in, but in English we don't say in the earth. We say on the earth. Whereas in Urdu, for example, we say zameen me, which is in. Okay. Anyway, ulaika, those are the ones who humul khasirun, the losers. Okay. Ulaika, those whom they. Ulaika, those are the ones who. It's like emphasis. Ulaika humul khasirun. This is one explanation. There are others also. Wallahu alam. Let's take lessons we already took. So we can say, oh Allah, help us obey you in all areas of life. Help us maintain the relations. Make us reformers instead of mufsideen. And help us be successful, to be successful in dunya and akhirah. Let's take asma and af'al. Ahd, plural is uhud, and mithaq, plural is mawathiq, and ard, aradi. Okay, and khasir, khasirun. So can you give me the plurals? Ahd, uhud, mithaq, mawathiq, ard, aradi. All right. And let's take the verbs on the pattern of fataha, nasara, daraba, sami'a. Yanquduna. Show me the TPI. So there are three steps here. For any verb, you have to show the TPI sign. So show me the TPI sign. Yanqudun. Okay, they break. After this, I will say, then what is he broke? You have to say it in Arabic. This is the second step. So yanquduna, you can make it singular. Yanqudu. And drop that ya, so naqada. And then you say, give the six keys, naqada yanqudu unqud, naqid manqud, naqd. Okay, so repeat after me. Naqada yanqudu unqud, naqada yanqudu unqud, naqid manqud, naqd. Naqid manqud, naqd. Once you do that, now you are having the control on all the words that occur in the Quran, almost all the words. All right. Second is yaqta'una, similar. Can you show the TPI sign for yaqta'una? Yaqta'una, they cut. So what will be he cut? Okay, that is cut. Everything is past, present, future in Arabic, in English. But I'm referring to past tense. He cut or he has cut. What will it be? So yaqta'un, make it singular. Yaqta'u, drop the ya. That will be qata'a. That's the way to come back also. So repeat after me. Qata'a yaqta'u iqta'. Qata'a yaqta'u iqta'. Qati' maqtu' qata'. Qati' maqtu' qata'. All right. Amara. Amara, he ordered. So that is something simple. Repeat. Amara ya'muru mur. Amara ya'muru mur. Amir ma'mur amr. Amir ma'mur amr. All right. Khasirun. 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 Losers. So what is he lost? Khasira. Okay. Repeat. Khasira yakhsaru. Ikhsar. Khasira yakhsaru. Ikhsar. Khasir. Makhsur. Khusr. Khasir. Makhsur. Khusr. Or khusran also. On the pattern of Wahaba Wa'ada, we have Yusala, that is passive voice. And you will learn that style of TPI in course number 5, I think in this course also. You see, actually it was Wasala Yasilu, Yasilu, Yusala. This is passive voice, is like receiving action, Yusala. Okay, be joined. And he joined is Wasala. Okay, Yusala is Yasilu actually. And this is wasala. Wasala yasilu is like wa'ada ya'idu. It's like tricky, but as you get used to them, used to seeing them, inshallah, you will learn them also. Repeat. Wasala yasilu sil. Wasala yasilu sil. Wasil mausul wusul. Wasil mausul wusul. All right. So that's about the lesson. So now let us go to Kahoot. Be ready with the Kahoot now. And let's see where we are. Okay, so we have page 4, pointer C, alhamdulillah, I'm ready. So I'm launching it. If you have any questions in between, you can answer till you join. Let me go to question answer section. There is no question, nothing is posted there. So looks like, mashallah, everybody is clear. Or if you want to type something, type in the question answer part till you join. 8485475. So any questions or somebody wants to raise a hand, we can raise allow them, our coordinators. You want to do that?
Yeah, sure, Aksa. As of now, there is no hands.
No hands. MashaAllah, people are eager to answer the questions. So that's fine. You know, for the teacher, it is easy to have, I mean, it is easier moment when there are no questions, but there are two questions, looks like. Okay. We didn't receive the certificate of the previous course till now. Well, there are two possibilities. One possibility, most probably, is the certificate has gone into spam email. You can check that. Other possibility, of course, is maybe it has been mistake or email was mistaken or whatever. So please write to admin and hopefully they will sort it out. But this is course 2 and you should, anyway, you can write from the people who conducted. I did my quiz yesterday, mashallah, Mubarak. All answers were correctly answered, but came back 3 answers as wrong. Okay, I don't know which one was that, but if you can type question and answer, I can answer it. Course 1 question and answers, Googling link to upload marks. There is no uploading of marks. You have to keep marks with yourself, but you will get a Google quiz for recording marks. But I think we cannot drag on to that. You have to talk to admin, please. Don't post it here. Somebody has received certificates from the previous course. That's great. This course was administered by our team here, so they are the ones issuing the course certificates. How does letter fa signifies the word yaqta'una? Letter fa, there is no fa. Fa yaqta'una means then, so fa yaqta'una is not there, so I don't know why you're saying letter fa. I didn't receive it in my spam also. Okay, please write it to the admin. All right. Any administrative questions, please write to the admin and don't post it for me because I'm not administering the courses. I'm teaching the course. Okay, so admin will answer you the administrative questions. All right, so let us start now. Okay, the first question is multi-select. Yanquduna, translate, yanquduna. They will break, they break, they broke, and they break.
The
There should be no broken. Okay. They break and they will break. That's the right answer. MashaAllah. Next one. Again, multi-select. Translate yaqta'una. They cut asunder and they cut asunder. They cut asunder. They will cut asunder. He will cut asunder. Yaqta'una. Yes, you know, all fa'il mudhari have two meanings, present and future. So they cut asunder and they will cut asunder. Third, amarallahu. Translate amarallahu. Allah has ordered, Allah will order, Allah orders, Allah does not order. Allah has ordered. MashaAllah. Very good. Allah will order. Let us take the wrong answers now. Allah will order. What will it be? Amara, he has ordered. This will be Ya'muru. Ya'muru, he will order or orders. Okay. The blue and the... Let me just pick the pen and let us annotate so you know where I am. So Allah will order means Ya'muru. I don't know why this is leaking so much. Okay, Ya'muru. And so this is Ya'muru. Okay, so I'm writing with mouse now. And Allah orders also means Ya'muru. Okay, so please remember this is wrong. Ya'muru is present. Amarallahu is fi'il madi. It's like past perfect. Allah has ordered. And at this level, inshallah, you should be masters of Madi and Mudare. All right. Next, again, is multi-select. That means, fail Mudare, wayufsiduna. Is it, and he causes corruption, they cause corruption, and they cause corruption, and they will cause corruption. Well, by now, you should be able to see from the tip of two meanings, which is present and future. Wayufsiduna. And so the meanings are, and they cause corruption. Okay, what is and? So and they cause corruption. Oh my God, why doesn't it pick up? Okay, and they cause corruption and they will cause corruption. All right, they cause corruption is right, but why is missing here? Okay, so and is missing here. That's why this is wrong. I hope you realize the mistake. You have to be precise. Let's go to the next question now. فعل مضارع قطع. قطع is ماضي. So what is this one? Is it يقطع قطع يقطع يقطع or يقطع يقطع or يقطع? First one is يقطع and last one green is يقطع. So be careful, even I slipped in my yaqta'u. Okay, not yaqta'u. It is yaqta'u. It's not on the pattern of yansuru. It is qata'a yaqta'u. It's like fataha yaftahu. Wa yaqta'una. So Quran will teach you. For example, Quran doesn't say wa yaqta'una. Okay, it is yaqta'una, which means on the pattern of fataha. It can be fataha or sami'a, but with the exposure, you will not know the second. فعل أمر في يخسر. يخسر, he loses. What is this one? Is it إخسر, إخسر, خسر, يخسر. أمر, lose. It doesn't make sense, much sense, but still. اخسر. And you know, don't forget that simple I would say trick or tip, which is yakhsaru. Whenever you want to make fi'il mudare, amr from fi'il mudare, yakhsaru. If you know fi'il mudare, just kill that ya, drop that ya, cut that ya. So what are you left with? Khsar. In Arabic, you don't start with a sakin letter, so you add a temporary hamza. Ikhsar. Okay, so it cannot be ikhsir, it cannot be ikhsur or ukhsur. The sa is defined here already, so it will be ikhsar. That's why this is correct. All right, so let's go to the next one. Plural of mithaq. Is it mithaqun, mawathiq, mawathiqun, or mithaqat? Okay, it is mawathiq. Sorry, I just clicked it faster. Next one. Again, multi-select. Allah's ahad is his standing command to mankind to submit to him, to obey him, to worship him alone, to believe in him. What is that ahd Allah which the fasiqeen break? Or fasiqoon break. What is that ahd? Alladhina yanquduna ahd Allah. So all of them. MashaAllah, excellent. All of them are right. You chose all of them. Let's go to the next one. Again, multi-select. Fasiqeen are losers because they lose the true peace of mind, the true peace of heart, the true love of relatives, and eternal happiness in Jannah. Actually, all are correct. They lose everything. The fasiqeen, those who break. In fact, the hadith of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is amazing. He says, احفظ الله يحفظك. Take care of Allah and Allah will take care of you. Subhanallah. أو كما قال صلى الله عليه وسلم. Again, multi-select. Today is all multi-select. Fasiqeen will not get guidance because they break the covenant of Allah, they break the relationships, they spread corruption on the earth, they deceive believers. As defined by the verse that we studied today. What are the fasiqeen? I mean, what do they do? They do not get guidance because they do all of this, but deceive believers is not directly mentioned in this verse. Okay, so it should not have been there. But anyway, let us see the toppers today, and then we go to the second part, which is grammar. Okay, so you have seen the toppers, HH, Yusha, and Brother Abdullah, and then we have IBS and Jasina. All right, Brother Harun, are you there?
Yes.
MashaAllah, excellent. So you're ready, so let me just show the toppers for a while. 65% played very well, mashallah. So these are the first 10 who are getting 100, and then we have 70s. So hundreds are gone, 10, 20, 30. Oh, there is one more 100, 40 and 50. Brother Harun, please take over. Jazakumullah khair.
الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين اللهم علمنا ما ينفعنا وانفعنا بما علمتنا وزدنا علما اللهم إنا نسألك علما نافعا ورزقا طيبا وعملا متقبلا السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. So continuing our discussion about the grammar, we'll just quickly go to our master table. This we have already covered. The repetition is just to make sure that you remember these things, as these verbs are really important. They are occurring, the sound verbs are occurring 9,000 times, which means in each line you will find one of them. These weak verbs are again now 9,000 times. So again, in each line you will find them. And the ones which are repeated, they are occurring 1,300 times, which means that on every page, you'll find them twice. So this master table, which we can call, is the one which would help us revise whatever we have covered till now from course 1 and course 2. So just a recall, if you open the Quran, Fataha, Allah will help you, Nasara, otherwise you will be hit, Daraba, therefore listen, Sami'a. And then for the weak verbs, Allah will give, it's a promise, Wahaba, Wa'ada. In fact, he said, he will give more, Qala, Zada. Therefore pray to him for guidance, Da'a, Hada. And have good opinion, otherwise you will be lost, Dhanna, Dalla. So we were covering Nasara in the previous session, and we had around 15 examples of Nasara on the Nasara pattern, which you covered in the previous session. And today we'll further go into more examples on the same Nasara pattern. So Nasara would be Nasara Yansuru Unsur, Nasir Mansur Nasr. So similar pattern is another word, which is kafara. So we'll do it together. You can do it after me. Kafara yakfuru ukfur. Kafara yakfuru ukfur. Kafir makfur kufr. Kafir makfur kufr. So the key over here is just make sure that you don't miss out this dhamma. And this Dhamma is another distinct thing in the Amr also. So wherever you find this Dhamma coming on the third letter, the Amr would also be beginning with the Dhamma. قُلْ يَا أَيُّهَا الْكَافِرُونَ is an example. Say, oh, disbelievers, which we have covered in the previous course. So another word which is following the same pattern is شَعَرَ. شَعَرَ يَشْعُرُ أُشْعُرُ شَعَرَ يَشْعُرُ أُشْعُرُ شَاعِرْ مَشْعُرْ شُعُرْ شَاعِرْ مَشْعُرْ شُعُرْ. And this is what you have covered in Surah Al-Baqarah, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala spoke about the munafiqeen. In the verse, يُخَادِعُونَ اللَّهَ وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَمَا يَخْدَعُونَ إِلَّا أَنفُسَهُمْ وَمَا يَشْعُرُونَ. And then the following verses, it came, أَلَا إِنَّهُمْ هُمُ الْمُفْسِدُونَ وَلَكِنْ لَا يَشْعُرُونَ. So that was covered within this course. صَدَقَ صَدَقَ يَصْدُقُ أُصْدُقُ صَادِقُ مَصْدُوقُ صِدْ. Once again, صَدَقَ يَصْدُقُ أُصْدُقُ صَدَقَ يَصْدُقُ أُصْدُقُ صَادِقْ مَصْدُوقْ صِدْقُ صَادِقْ مَصْدُوقْ صِدْقُ إِن كُنْتُمْ صَادِقِينَ. So that is also covered once, if you recall the challenge verse in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave a challenge to these disbelievers who don't believe in the ayat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bring a surah like it, in kuntum sadiqeen, if you are truthful. So then we have fasaqa. Fasaqa yafsuqu ufsuq. Once again, fasaqa yafsuqu ufsuq. Fasiq dash fisq. Fasiq dash fisq. وَمَا يُضِلُّ بِهِ إِلَّا الْفَاسِقِينَ. The same verse which was covered in the previous sessions. وَمَا يُضِلُّ بِهِ إِلَّا الْفَاسِقِينَ. So then we have كَتَمَ. كَتَمَ يَكْتُمُ أُكْتُمُ. كَتَمَ يَكْتُمُ أُكْتُمُ. كَاتِم مَكْتُوم كِتْمَان. كَاتِم مَكْتُوم كتمان. So that is a verse which you will cover in the upcoming sessions where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is mentioning to, it's related to the conversation with the angels and Adam alayhi salam, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells to Adam alayhi salam to convey the names which he had taught him. And then in the end, it is said, قال ألم أقل لكم إني أعلم غيب السماوات والأرض وأعلم ما تبدون وما كنتم تكتمون. And he knows whatever you know, what you are concealing. وما كنتم تكتمون, you are concealing. So this was a verb which occurs, 190 such kind of verbs occur in Quran, which have a repetition of 3,800 times. So that is an important pattern which is being followed in Quran. So you need to be very well in that. So by this, we had a lot of examples, and inshallah, this while practicing these examples, it would help you a lot in applying this verb while reading, while understanding the Quran. So the other topic which we will come into, it would be daraba. The other verb would be the style on of daraba. So daraba, just to break it down so that we are well aware that these keys are further to be broken down. So daraba, darabu, darabta, darabtu, darabtum, darabna. And then yadribu, yadribu, yadribun, tadribu, adribu. تضربون نضرب. Then for the amr, اضرب اضربوا لا تضرب لا تضرب ضارب مضروب ضرب. So now the words which are going to follow the same pattern, one of them is رجع رجع يرجع ارجع رجع يرجع ارجع راجع داش رجوع راجع داش رجوع فهم لا يرجعون. This is the verse which you covered earlier, صمم بكم عمي فهم لا يرجعون, they will not return. ظلم ظلم يظلم اظلم ظلم يظلم. So now you will notice that this amr is getting back to the normal situation where it would be having a kasra. The third letter is not having a dhamma. If it had a dhamma, then we would have placed dhamma on the amr, also on the hamza of the amr. So here it would be following the same natural pattern, the usual pattern. Idlim, zalim, mazloom, zulm, zalim. مظلوم ظلم فتكون من الظالمين. This is a verse which we'll cover inshallah later. فتكون من الظالمين, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala addresses Adam alayhi salam and his wife that you shouldn't be going near that particular tree. If you would go there, فتكون من الظالمين. So then we have another word which is malaka, following the same pattern of daraba. Malaka yamliku imlik. Malaka yamliku imlik. Malik mamluk milk. Malik mamluk milk. Maliki yawmiddin is a very well known verse for to you. Then we have kathaba. Kathaba yakthibu ikthib. Kathaba yakthibu. اكذب كاذب مكذوب كذب كاذب مكذوب كذب كانوا يكذبون. Then we have قدر قدر يقدر اقدر قدر يقدر اقدر قادر او قدير مقدور قدر قادر قدير مقدور قدر إن الله على كل شيء قدير, which comes several times in Quran.
So you have covered six verbs of following the daraba pattern. So they occur 636 times in Quran, and we have 115 such verbs that occur 1,750 times in the Quran. So quickly we'll go to the spoken Arabic part, and you can quickly answer me after I ask you these questions. هل كفرت؟ ما كفرت. هل كفرتم؟ ما كفرنا. هل تكفروا؟ لا أكفر. هل تكفرون؟ لا نكفر. لا تكفر. لا أكفر. لا تكفروا. لا نكفر. So similarly for صدق. هل صدقت؟ نعم صدقت. هل صدقتم؟ نعم صدقنا.
السلام عليكم brother Harun, mashallah, jazakallah khair. Just give a little space between your question and answer, right, so that people also think.
All right, but we were just short of time, so that is
no
why.
No problem. Carry on.
All right. هل تصدق؟ نعم أصدق. هل تصدقون؟ نعم نصدق. أصدق أصدق. أصدقوا نصدقوا. So similarly for تشعروا. Do you perceive؟ هل تشعروا؟ So this is the مضارع. نعم أشعر. هل تشعرون؟ نعم نشعر. And then for the منافقين, keeping them in mind, so you can ask the question, did they do this first? هل فسقوا؟ نعم فسقوا. هل يفسقون؟ نعم يفسقون. So this would be like on the right side. هل فسقوا؟ نعم فسقوا. هل يفسقون؟ نعم يفسقون. هل ظلمت؟ ما ظلمت. هل ظلمتم؟ ما ظلمنا. هل تظلموا؟ لا أظلم. هل تظلمون؟ لا نظلم. So the أمر لا تظلم. لا أظلم. In negation. لا تظلموا. لا نظلم. So then for the practice for كذب. هل كذبت؟ So this is ماضي. ما كذبت. So you need to remember that for ماضي you are going to answer with negation with ما, and for مضارع with لا. هل كذبتم؟ ما كذبنا. هل تكذب؟ لا أكذب. هل تكذبون؟ لا نكذب. لا تكذب. Do not lie. لا أكذب. لا تكذبوا. لا نكذب. So finally, we have another question. هل ترجعوا إلى الله? Of course, we need to remember that we have to return to Allah سبحانه وتعالى. هل ترجعوا إلى الله? نعم. أرجع إلى الله. هل ترجعون إلى الله? نعم. نرجع إلى الله. So that's all.
MashaAllah, Jazakallah khair. That's wonderful. So let us go for Kahoot now. I posted the number and you will see the number right now, 282637. And I should tell here that MashaAllah, you see, the second course is so simple. We are just revising the six forms from now onwards. So page number 4 and 5, it's all about, most of it is about revision only. So all we have learned is just weak verbs. So, and inshallah, course 5 also will be similarly very simple. So Quran is becoming easier, I should say. But if you practice, if you don't practice, then you will lose the connection. 282637. You can post the questions. I will see if there are any questions. Question, no. This coding for me will not help. QS 2, 5, and 8. If you can type question and answer, it will be easier. So you can please type complete question. Then I can be able to answer it easily. All right, so we will start now. 282637, 282637, remember it, 282637. Question number one, three noun keys of fasaqa. Noun keys are like fa'il, maf'ul, fa'il. So is it fasaqa yafsuqu fisq or fasiq dash fisq or fasaqa yafsuqu ufsuq or fasiq yafsuqu ufsuq? The rest right answer is fasiq dash fisq. Fasiq, the one who disobeys defiantly, means disobeying, so nobody is affected. So this is dash, and fisq is to disobey. Okay. These are verbs. Fasaqa yafsuqu are verbs, and fasiq is noun, but yafsuqu is a verb. So we are talking about noun keys. Okay. Noun keys. Fasiq. All right. The next question is see the toppers, and then three verb keys of raja'a, like fa'ala, yaf'alu, if'al. Verb keys are, is it raji' dash ruju', raja'a yarji'u ruju', and raji' ruju' yarji'u, and raja'a yarji'u irji'. It is raja'a yarji'u ruju'. Raja'a yarji'u, not ruju'. That's not ruju'. This is wrong. Astaghfirullah. I just checked it, but subhanallah, it missed my eyes. It is raja'a yarji'u irja'. All of you, the 131 are right, and this is wrong. Subhanallah. Humans. Okay, next. Multi-select. Yakvibun, translate. Yakvibun, yakvibun. They are lying, you are lying. They will lie, and they lied. They are lying and they will lie. L-I-E, actually, anyway. They will lie, they are lying in the present and future. MashaAllah, most of you got it right. They lie and they will lie. Translation of sha'aru, sha'aru, they perceive, they will perceive, he perceives, they perceived. Sha'aru is for plural, okay, and it is for madi. Amilu, fa'alu, ja'alu, sha'aru, they perceived, okay. They perceive will be, what is it? They perceive, anybody? That is yash'urun. They perceive is yash'urun. They perceive is yash'urun. All right. Next is translate, you know, they disbelieve. Translate into Arabic. Is it yakfuru, yakfurun, kafaru, or kafara? Yakfurun, yakfurun, they disbelieve. Yakfuru, he disbelieves. Okay. هل تصدقون, do you say the truth? Are you truthful? هل تصدقون, do you say the truthful things? So you should say, yes, we say the truthful things, or we say the truth. So what will it be? Yes, we say. Is it نصدق, تصدقون, صدقنا, نستصدق? نصدق. Yes, هل تصدقون, نصدق. All right. Yes, we say. صدقنا will be past tense. Yes, we said the truth. But نصدق, we say the truth. Because the question was, do you say? هل تصدقون? MashaAllah. هل نصركم الله? Did Allah help you? That's a tricky question. So you should say, yes, Allah helped me. Is it نصرني, ينصرنا, نصرنا, نصركم? نصركم helped, نصركم helped you. So نصر, yeah, that. There is something you people got lost, and there is so much confusion. We said Nasara, he helped. So now think about it. The TPI will solve it much easier. Okay, Nasara means he helped. Kum, you all. Nasara, kum, who? Allah helped you all. Allah. The question was, did Allah help you, or did Allah help you? In English, you have to rearrange things. But anyway, did Allah help you? Helped you. So you have to say, yes, na'am, helped me. Nasara ni, help me. Not na. 67 people said na. Am I saying it? Yes, you 67 said it right. And 70 opted it for wrong. My brain is not working today. So this is wrong. Why? Nasarana. So you answered right. Nasarakum, you also helped. You also, Nasarana, yes, helped us. Nasarana is right. But people chose Nasarani. Nasarani means help me, which is wrong. Nasarani is wrong because we are saying helped you all. Kum. So answer of kum will be na. Answer of kum will be na. Naam nasarana Allahu. So 67 people said it right and nasarani is wrong. If I had asked, hal nasaraka Allahu, did Allah help you alone? Hal nasaraka, then the answer will be naam nasarani. Yes, Allah helped me. Okay. So nasaraka will be nasarani, but nasarakum will be nasarana. Orange. Naam nasarana. Sorry for that confusion. Let's go to the next one. Hal hum raji'una ilallah. Are they going towards Allah? Hal hum raji'una ilallah. So answer is na'am, huwa raji'un, or hum raji'un, or anta raji', or nahnu raji'un. I'm talking about them. Are they going to Allah? So you should say, yes, they are going to Allah. Whenever the question is about them, nothing changes. Very good. Na'am, hum raji'una ilallah. You just say, you add na'am. The rest is all same as in question. Hal hum raji'un, na'am hum raji'un. This part doesn't change when it is about third person. It's only about you and me that the tense changes or the word changes. Okay. All right. Let's go to the next one. La yash'urun. Translate. He does not perceive. They do not perceive. You do not perceive. They did not perceive. لا يشعرون لا يشعرون they do not perceive يشعرون it's for them okay they do not perceive 14 people said they did not perceive that is ما شعروا okay we negate ماضي with ما so this will be ما شعروا They did not perceive. Okay. But we are asking لا يشعرون, so they do not perceive. Okay. All right. Let's go to the next one. Last question. إن كنتم صادقين. Is it too much there in the Quran? If they are truthful, if he is truthful, if we are truthful, if you all are truthful. إن كنتم صادقين. If you all are truthful. Okay, that is the right answer. The green, if you all are truthful. Kuntum. See, you all are. Kana, kanu. Kunta, kuntu. Kuntum, you all are. Now, 37 people said, if they are truthful. For they, it will be, what will be the answer? Can you think of the answer very quickly? I'm going to answer it now. Kana, kanu. In kanu sadiqin. So if they are truthful, it will be in kanu sadiqin. But we asked in kuntum, that is you all. All right. So let us go to the toppers. Okay, so we have Brother Hamza, Sister Asma and Asmon, and Abdullah and Dr. Muhammad. 63% played it well. So let us see the report. And let's see the players. So we have 10, 20, 30, 40, and 50. All right, now is the time to go for another one, which is Quran part for 4D.
Doctor, we have two questions, so can you answer?
Go ahead.
How to know the particular words in which pattern? Is in the Quran, suppose some new words coming, and which pattern it is? So that asking question, one question.
Well, the simplest answer is as you get used to exposure. That's why, that's exactly the reason you can see that for, you know, so many sessions we are revising all those verbs. Like last session, just 4C grammar, we gave you all Nasara pattern questions, all Daraba pattern questions, all Fataha pattern questions. So this in this course, we will do a lot of these exposure and practice, number one. Number two, if you go to our website, you can download the booklet 85% of Quranic words, then you will find many patterns of these types of verbs. So the brief answer is, there are some clues like yaqta'un. So it is not yaqtu'un. So either it is sami'a yasma'u or fataha yaftahu. Okay. And similarly, for example, yazlimun. Yazlimun. So this is yazlimu. So it can be only Zalama yazlimu. You know, most 95% of the case, or 99%, it is on Zaraba yadribu. So the present tense gives you some clue. Okay. So as you get used to these patterns, inshallah, more and more. So at this point, try to learn as much vocabulary as possible. Don't fall into the trap of grammar too much. Okay. Because people, you know, there are many Arabic courses. They learn lots of terminologies of grammar, fi'l, mudare, marfu', and these, and mubtada, and khabar. And by learning these loads of terminologies of grammar, they think they are learning so much of Arabic. Learn as much vocabulary as possible, and then you will, and also in parallel, grammar, like we are doing, inshallah. So that is much more helpful. And do practice, read it, repeat, read the Quran again and again. learn more and more grammar. Astaghfirullah. Learn more and more vocabulary, and then you will, inshallah, learn the grammar automatically when you follow, you know, inshallah, these brief grammar exposures. All right, so let us go to the next lesson, which is lesson number 4D. It's page number 4, pointer D. We are on page number 4. The pointers, the first three pages are, we are praising Allah, asking for guidance, and this guidance for muttaqeen. And this is the book of guidance, and for muttaqeen, not for kafirin, not for munafiqeen, because they are corrupt and double-faced. And the first example is fire. Second example is of rain. Okay, so it is here. And Quran's call and Quran's guidance. We are on the fourth page, and the pointers on fourth page are Quran's warning, Quran's examples, Quran's, I mean, kind of misguidance for fasiqeen. So I'm linking it with all Quran, Quran, Quran. You can do it also. These pointers are not like revealed from Allah. This is just made up for facility. You can have your own pointers also. So warning, mosquito, astray, you can go like this, or to learn it easily, say Quran's warning, Quran's examples, Quran's, you know, Quran's misguidance for fasiqin. And then how can you disbelieve? So the last is, how can you disbelieve after all these clarity is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying. So in previous verses describing Quran's call, Allah asked us to worship Him alone. Now He's presenting the same thing in a different way. That is, how can you reject when this so simply is presented? So we cannot deny Allah, because our life, our death, our resurrection is in His hands. We have to go back to Him. All provisions have to have a comfortable life are given by Allah. He knows everything, including our thoughts and actions. All right, so let us start. A'udhu billahi minash shaitan. It's so simple. In fact, I still remember one of the lectures by Sheikh Ahmad Didat, rahimahullah. He was in London at the time, and he was presenting a lecture to a group of people on the presence of God. So there were Buddhists and maybe other people also present, and they were talking about, you know, Allah is there or God is there. And they were presenting their own arguments, and Ahmad Didat presented this verse. It's a beautiful verse. Allah says, كَيْفَ تَكْفُرُونَ بِاللَّهِ أَعُوذُ بِاللَّهِ مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ الرَّجِيمِ كَيْفَ تَكْفُرُونَ بِاللَّهِ وَكُنْتُمْ أَمْوَاتًا فَأَحْيَاكُمْ ثُمَّ يُمِيتُكُمْ ثُمَّ يُحْيِيكُمْ ثُمَّ إِلَيْهِ تُرْجَعُونَ. How can you disbelieve in Allah when you are lifeless and He brought you to life? Okay, your existence, who brought you? Then He will cause you to die. Then He will bring you back to life. Then to Him you will be returned. And the second verse also is beautiful. So it's a very simple, logical, common sense question. Only a stupid or somebody who is arrogant will reject this presentation. So let us go word by word. Kaifa means how. In Arabic we say kaifa al-hal, how are you? How is the condition? Meaning how are you? Kaifa haluk? Okay. So kaifa means how. Kaifa takfurun, how can you disbelieve, billahi, in Allah, wa kuntum amwatan, and you were, or when you were, or while you were, lifeless, amwatan, plural, okay, you were dead. Fa ahyakum, fa means then, ahya, He gave life, okay, He brought you to life. This is advanced form, you will learn it in the next course. Ahyakum, then He brought you to life. Thumma, then yumitu, this is also advanced form. Amata yumitu, ahya yuhyi, this is advanced form. Mazid fi, you will learn it in the next course. Thumma yumitukum, He will give you deaths, or He will cause you to die. Thumma yuhyikum, then He will bring you back to life. So ahya means He brought you to life. Yuhyi, He brings you to life, or He will bring you to life. Ahya yuhyi. Amata yumitu. You will learn this later on. Thumma ilayhi, then to Him turja'oon, you will be returned. Tarji'oon, you return. Turja'oon is passive voice. This is how we say it, okay? Like receiving hand. See, fa'il means the one who does. Maf'ool, the one who is affected. So here it is affected. So this tarji'un, you return. Turja'un, you are returned. You will be returned. Okay, present or future. So this is the sign for passive voice. It's very simple, okay? And TPI is so powerful that in one sign, we say five things. Okay, if I lift my right hand, that is the first thing that is, if I lift my right hand, it is masculine. If it is left hand, it's feminine. If I lift up to here, this is madhi. If I lift up to here, it's mudare. Two things. If I keep one finger, it is singular. If I keep four fingers, it is plural. Right? And there's the third. And if I keep it here, that is third person, second person, first person. That's the fourth thing. And if I keep it like this, it is active voice, فعل معروف. And if I keep it like this, it is passive voice, فعل مجهول. So TPI, in one sign, I say five things. ترجعون. So it's wonderful. And if I were in a live class, I would have asked you, like, say, you know, mashallah, 200 of you sitting in the whole hall, I will say, okay, show me turja'un. And in one sight, I will know how many of you have understood it. So simple. And then if I say, well, actually, turja'un is like this. So in one sign, all of you will have understood that it is masculine, it is plural, it is mudari', it is second person, and it is passive voice. So please, you know, try to perfect in TPI and you will benefit a lot. All right. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, you are dust, you are nothing, and Allah brought you to life. And only Allah knows when and where we will die. So we cannot defy Allah because our life, our death, and our resurrection is in His hands. And we have to go back to Him. Therefore, we cannot afford to be careless. Actually, you know, once I was lecturing to non-Muslim group, and somebody said, well, enjoy life, man. Why do you care about this God and hereafter and this book and prophets? Just have fun. So this is another very important point. ثُمَّ إِلَيْهِ تُرْجَعُونَ. Or you can also say, this is first thing. Second thing is, I told him, I mean, alhamdulillah, Allah gave the idea. So suppose you wake up tomorrow in a hotel, in a resort, okay, where people are serving you. What will be your first question? Will it be, oh, have fun? No, you will say, who brought me here? I was sleeping in my room. Who brought me here? And people say, no, man, have fun. Everything is there. Food is there. You will be scared. You will say, well, I don't know why I'm brought here. That will be your first question. That question is valid even today. Just because we are living here on this earth for the past 20, 30, 40, 50 years doesn't mean that it is granted. No, you should be asking, who brought me here? Why am I here and where am I going? And Allah says, it is He who did it. ثُمَّ إِلَيْهِ تُرْجَعُ. The next verse is, so can you translate? We don't have time, so let us go to the next verse. هُوَ الَّذِي خَلَقَ لَكُمْ مَا فِي الْأَرْضِ جَمِيعًا ثُمَّ اسْتَوَى إِلَى السَّمَاءِ فَسَوَّاهُنَّ سَبْعَ سَمَاوَاتٍ وَهُوَ بِكُلِّ شَيْءٍ عَلِيمٍ. He is the one. It is He who created you, for you, that which is on the earth. All of it. Then He directed Himself to the heaven and made them seven heavens. And He is of all things, all knowing. هو الذي, it is He who خلق لكم, created for you. And for you, there is a world of messages in that. لكم, the word لكم has a world of messages. What I mean is Allah didn't need to do that. It is for you He did it. So you should be so much thankful. مَا فِي الْأَرْضِ جَمِيعًا. Everything on the earth is created for you. Like I told you once, Dr. Zakir Naik was lecturing in Dubai and one of the atheists came and he said, Allah says He created heavens, He created earth, He created this. What is great for Allah? Why does he say keep saying, you know, he created? Well, he's God. He should be, I mean, it's trivial for him to create earth. So why does he keep saying that? That was a very tricky question. And the answer is in that lakum. Of course, Allah didn't have to create anything, but he created it for you. It is the favor for you. Lakum ma fil ardi jami'an. Everything that is in the earth. See how kind and caring. He didn't have to do anything for you. You would be suffering somewhere, born in a desert and, you know, roasted to death. But he made sure that everything is provided for you. ثُمَّ اسْتَوَى. Then he directed himself إِلَى السَّمَاءِ, to the heaven. فَسَوَّاهُنَّ. Then he made them سَبْعَ سَمَاوَاتِ. سَبْعَ is seven. SubhanAllah, the word سَبْعَ سَمَاوَاتِ, this phrase is mentioned in the Quran seven times. That's another miracle of the Quran. There are so many. وَهُوَ بِكُلِّ شَيْءٍ عَلِيمٍ. And he is of all things, all-knowing. He knows everything. All right, so what is the message here? It is Allah's mercy, as we said, and loving care that he gave us all provisions to have a comfortable life. He created everything for us. For example, if apples and oranges, like I mentioned perhaps before also, were of millimeters in size, we could not eat them. Can we? Could we? You know, just imagine peeling the oranges of millimeter size and eating million of them. Allah created the huge sky with billions and billions of stars in it and put six more skies above it, Saba'a Samawat. And he knows every creature. This should create an amazement about Allah in our hearts. Allah created everything for us, and this should help us love him. All right, so in summary, we can say, oh Allah, help us ponder your creation and increase our faith. This is very, 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 very important message, okay? If you want to increase the faith, we should ponder the creation of Allah. Get a book on astronomy, not like a villager. Huh? Oh yeah, this is a great sky. No, you are educated, so you should watch a one-hour maybe a documentary on the space, or 2 hours or 3 hours, or every month or every 2 months, 3 months, you should keep watching what is going on in the space or in the earth or in ourselves. Or take a book on astronomy, buy it, study it. Take a book on sciences, maybe of kids, you know, they're studying in school. Take that book and study it for the sake of Allah. That is called pondering. That's called serious pondering. Not just like, you know, oh yeah, this is something interesting. Tafakkur is ibadah. Yatafakkaruna fi khalqi samawat is ibadah, is worship. If you take with the intention of studying the creation of Allah, that is worship. Oh Allah, fill our hearts with your greatness. Help us stay away from sins. All right, so let's take asma. Amwat is plural of mayyit. Mayyit is dead person. Amwat, dead persons. Okay. Next is Ard, plural is Aradi. We just saw it in the previous lesson. Sama, plural is Samawat. All right, can you give me the plurals? Mayyit, Amwat, Ard, Aradi, Sama, Samawat. All right, Shay, Ashiya. Okay, Shay, Ashiya. Let's take the verbs on the pattern of Fataha, Nasara, Daraba, Sami'a. Takfurun, I said three steps. Show the sign, okay? And then we'll say takfur. So what is takfurun? It's like this. You all disbelieve. So what is he disbelieved? So I'm coming from English to Arabic. What is he disbelieved? And the easiest is takfurun, yakfurun. Make it singular. Yakfuru, and drop the ya. So what are you left with? Kafara. So either it is kafira or kafara. Okay? Kafara. It is kafara because yakfurun, yansuru. So it cannot be sami'a, yasmu'u. No. It is Nasara Yansuru, so kafara. So this is a trick to find out the patterns, okay? So I'm giving you the clues. Takfurun kafara. So give me the six keys. Repeat after me. Kafara yakfuru ukfur. Kafara yakfuru ukfur. Kafir makfur kufr. Kafir makfur kufr. Turja'un. Show me the TPI sign. Turja'un. passive voice, receiving hand, turja'un, tarji'un, turja'un. So this is tarji'un, yarji'un, okay, yarji'un. So you see, yarji'un is like yadribun. So it is like raja'a yarji'u. This is daraba yadribu. See the pattern? I'm giving you the clues. Again, repeat, raja'a yarji'u, irji', raja'a yarji'u, irji', raji' dash ruju', raji' dash ruju'. And by the way, these are different patterns, as you have seen in the previous grammar practice. There are different patterns. There are 40 different patterns, but don't be scared. You will learn one by one. In English, there is not even a rule there, and you keep learning all of them. So here, at least there are some patterns. Rujur or Raja. There are more than one patterns also. More than one pattern. Khalaqa. He created. Well, that is already the key, the main key. And you know the rest. You did it in first course. Khalaqa yakhluqu ukhluq khaliq makhluq khalq. So I'm not going to practice that. Let's take the weak verbs. Three letter weak verbs. Kuntum. Show the sign. Kuntum. Kuntum. You all were. So he is kana. And you did this in first course. A second course. Kana yakunu kun kain dash kaun. Okay. Repeat. Kana yakunu kun kana yakunu kun kain dash kaun. Kain dash kaun. Alhamdulillah. So now is the time to go for the Kahoot. So let us see, where is Kahoot? There we are. So any questions, please? You can ask questions till we go to the Kahoot.
How can none be affected in fisk? Means maf'ul. They're asking about the maf'ul in the fisk.
Okay, we keep saying that again and again, but no problem. Let me explain it again every time this question comes. You see, there are many verbs where nobody is affected. For example, I slept. Nama. As-salatu khayrun min an-nawm. Nawm is to sleep. Okay, I slept. So if I say, sorry, let me just search this pointer D. So let me just play first. Okay, and you can keep joining and I answer the questions. Classic, start. Oh, no, you cannot start until some person joins. Okay, 4640, that's the smallest number we got so far. Okay, 4640. So Nama means he slept, right? Nama ya namu, nam. Naim, the one who sleeps. Is anybody affected if somebody is sleeping? The effect is on himself. Okay, nama. So naim, the one who sleeps. Nobody slept, nobody is affected. This is dash. So there are many. Qama, he stood up. Qaim, the one who stands. Is anybody affected? Nobody. Okay, dash. Similarly, fasaqa, he disobeyed. Well, fasiq, the one who disobeys. Maybe you can make it mafsuq if you want to make it, but I have not seen the application. But there are some verbs where this object is not there. Okay, in English, they are called transitive and intransitive verbs. Like transitive verbs which have object, intransitive don't have objects. But you don't have to worry. Even if you make fasiq mafsuq, no problem. Mafsuq will not come in the Quran, not come in Arabic language. As simple as that. You want to make qa'im maqum, no problem. Go ahead. Na'im, the sleep, the one who sleeps, manum, no problem. The manum will not come anywhere in the Arabic language or in any book. So if you want to make, go ahead. Don't be too much worried as to what happens. Okay, so 4640, let us start. 4640. Kaifa takfurun, translate, very simple. You all disbelieve, you will all disbelieve. How can you disbelieve? They disbelieved. Kaifa is how, so the answer was so simple. I mean, the tip was there. How word should have been included everywhere to confuse you. But anyway, how can you disbelieve? That's the right answer. Please switch off your mics. فَأَحْيَاكُمْ. Translate. فَأَحْيَاكُمْ. He brought you to life. Then he brought you to life. He brings you to life. Allah will bring you to life. فَأَحْيَاكُمْ. Okay, then he brought you to life. Very simple. All right. We gave you easy options so that you don't get misled. Turja'un. Thumma ilayhi turja'un. You will return. You all will return. They will be returned. You all will be returned. Turja'un is passive voice. Okay, be careful. You all will be returned. It is not you will return. 58 people said you all will return. That is tarji'un. Turja'un, you all will be returned. This is passive voice, okay? All right, next one. Fasawwa hunna. Translate. Fasawwa hunna. And he made him, and he made them, and he makes them, and he will make them. فَسَوَّاهُنَّ. And he made them. You see, sometimes fa is translated as and also. Okay, fa is sometimes translated as and also. And he made them. All right, next one. فعل ماضي of كائن. كائن is like فاعل. So what is فعل ماضي? Is it كانا, كاونا, يكونو or كائن? كانا. Yes, كانا. Well, orange people says yakunu. That's not fi'il madi. That's fi'il mudari. Okay, yakunu is fi'il mudari. Kana is fi'il madi. All right. Ism maf'ul of khalaqa. Maf'ul is, this is fa'il, this is maf'ul. Ism maf'ul. So what is this one? For khalaqa, khalaqa yakhluqu ukhluq, khaliq. What is this? So ism maf'ul means the noun. Passive participle is a very challenging terminology. Passive participle. It's passive, you know, it's related to affected. Okay. So, makhluq, the one who is affected. The passive participle word. Makhluq. MashaAllah. You got it. So, remember the word ism maf'ul, the noun which is for the one who is affected. The name of the one who is affected. Plural of sama. Is it sama'at, asma, sama'wat, or sama'un? That's very simple. The one who reads the Quran, this is not something unfamiliar. Very simple. Sama'wat. Okay, sama'wat. Okay, next one. Multi-select. Allah knows. What is that? When we will die, how we will die, how many years we live, where we will die. Well, the question is too obvious. ثُمَّ يُمِيتُكُمْ. He will cause you to die. And he knows when, how many, after how many years and where. MashaAllah. Next one, multi-select. Allah created for us the earth, the heavens, the comfortable life, all provisions we need. خَلَقَ لَكُمْ مَا فِي الْأَرْضِ جَمِيعًا. Everything that is there on the earth. Allah All answers are correct, mashallah. So let us go to the next one. Again, multi-select. We cannot deny Allah because dash dash is in his hands. Our life, our death, our resurrection, our judgment. Okay, all are correct. Our judgment, meaning the judgment that he will pass on us on the day of judgment. May Allah, you know, have mercy on us on that day. All right, so here are the toppers. Sister Asma, Dr. Muhammad, Ismail, and then we have Sister Amina and two more. Sister Maryam and Brother Afzan. I think it's brother, but anyway, let's say next. And mashallah, 76% played it well. That's very nice. I'm not wanting to play again, view full report. So let's see the other toppers. Because, you know, the reason I'm displaying that is maybe your internet is slow, your questions are right. So it's not necessary that you are in the top five. There are all those who are thinking and answering, mashallah, here, the 10 who got 90%, most of them. Again, we have 100% also, who got 100% also. So many people are getting 100%. Getting 100 is important. And so, mashallah, 50 people are there. I mean, I showed 50 toppers. And now, is Brother Abdul Rahim, are you there?
Yes, now I come to Allah.
Walaikum
as-salam.
So please go ahead.
You need access to screen share, please, panelist.
Done.
Yeah, JazakAllah. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, wa salatu wa salam ala ashraf al-anbiya'i wal mursaleen, nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi al-ma'in. Rabbi shrahli sadri wa yassir li amri wa ahlul 'uqdatan min lisani yafqahu qawli. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Yeah, it's 4B grammar part we are doing, inshallah. In this we'll take the weak verbs. We have already done the sum, but we'll continue from where we have stopped from the previous lesson, inshallah. So we will be doing, inshallah, sami'a pattern, the new verb, sami'a. Let us have a quick review of the previous.
You are still in the first slide. We do have the same question again. Are you in the first slide?
Yeah, it's moving a little bit slow, Dr. Sir.
Okay.
It was moving. And, yeah. So we have seen the sound verbs and the weak letter verbs. We have seen fataha, then the nasara, then daraba, then sami'a. So, can you give the answer if
no, Brother Abdul Rahim, still the screen is not clear.
Yeah, my eyes thing here, cursor says it's still in the execution. Okay. I'll say once again, sharing this one. So we have seen these four sound verbs, fataha, nasara, daraba, and sami'a. So fataha, if you open Quran, yani fataha, Allah will help you, nasara, or else you will be hit, daraba. So it's better we listen, sami'a. What's happening? Okay, I'll just close and start again.
Yeah, it's recommended.
Yeah, yeah, just a minute, please. I think it is.
Brother Abdul Rahim, let me share the screen, okay?
Ji, ji, Joseph.
Okay, I'm sharing the screen. Go ahead. With the sheet, that is much easier. So I don't have to... Do you see that?
Yeah, but there was a revision in that. So
this is the revision, yes. Samia, start from Samia.
Okay, fine. So Samia is he listened. And this is the fourth, from the sound verbs, fataha, then nasara, then daraba, then samia. If you open Quran, yani fataha, Allah will help us, nasara, or else we'll be hit, daraba, so it's better we listen. So here are the six important forms of samia, three verbs and three nouns. First, we'll do the complete cycle, then inshallah, we'll move on to the short table. Samia is he listened, and sami'u, they all listen. We will do only the Arabic one. Sami'a, sami'u, sami'ta, sami'tu, sami'tum, sami'na. Yasma'u. Once you know yasma'u, it's all easy. Yasma'u, yasma'una, tasma'u, asma'u, tasma'una, nasma'u. Isma', listen. Isma', isma'u. La tasma', la tasma'u. So three were the important verbs. You can see the highlighted thing on the screen. Sami'a, yasma'u, isma. These three are verbs. And now the nouns, sami', the listener, the one who listens. Sami', masmur, the one who is listened to. And sami' or sama'a. Both are okay. So three are verbs. Sami'a, yasma'u, isma. Sami', masmur, sam are the nouns of it. So on the same pattern, we have alima. Like sami'a yasma'u, alima ya'lamu. When once it rhymes in past and the present, it belongs to the same pattern. So no need to do the complete one. We'll see only the short. Alima he knew. Alima he knew. Alima. Like inni a'lamu ma la ta'lamu, Allah said in Quran. And the above example, sami'a, best example was sami'a Allahu liman hamida. Daily we say while getting up from the ruku. Alima ya'lamu i'lam. Alima ya'lamu i'lam. Three are the verbs. Alim, the one who knows. Alim, ma'lum, ilm. Alim, ma'lum, ilm. Once again, alima, ya'lamu, i'lam. Alim, ma'lum, ilm. Then we have amila. Amila is also same style, alima style. Belongs to samia. Sami'a yasma'u, alima ya'lamu. Okay. So in the sequence, if we listen sami'a, we will know alima. Then we will act amila. So here is a beautiful sequence to remember. Okay. Amila is he acted. Okay. He did amila. Like Allah said, illa ladin amur wa amilu salihat. Amila amilu. Amila he did, amilu they did. Amila ya'malu i'mal. Three verbs. Amila, ya'malu, i'mal. Amil, the doer, the one who does. Amil, ma'amul, amal. Amil, ma'amul, amal. All together once. Amila, ya'malu, i'mal. Amil, ma'amul, amal. One last time. Amila, ya'malu, i'mal. Amil, ma'amul, amal. Then we have hamida. Alhamdulillah, the best example is Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. Okay, hamida, he praised. Hamida. Sami Allahu liman hamida, also we say while getting up from the ruku. Hamida, yahmadu, ihmad. Hamida, yahmadu, ihmad. Three are the verbs and three nouns. Hamid, the one who praises, the one who praises. Hamid, Mahmud, the one who's praised. So we are Hamid, Allah is Mahmud. Hamid, Mahmud, Hamd. Like Alhamdulillah. Hamid, Mahmud, Hamd. Once again, Hamida, Yahmadu, Ihmad. Hamid, Mahmud, Hamd. Then we have Khasira. We have seen in course one, in Surah Al-Asr, Inna al-insana lafi khusr. The man who is in loss. Okay, khasira means he was in loss. Khasira yakhsaru اخسر خسر يخسر اخسر three verbs and three nouns خاسر مخسور خسر or خسران as well خاسر مخسور خسر like we saw in Surah An-Nasr إن الإنسان لفي خسر so all together once خسر يخسر اخسر خاسر مخسور خسر then we have شهيدا daily we say the statement أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله okay bearing witness شهيدا is he bore witness شهيدا شهيدا يشهد اشهد three verbs شهيدا يشهد اشهد شاهد مشهود شهادة three nouns شاهد مشهود شهادة all together once شهيدا يشهد اشهد شاهد مشهود شهادة three verbs and three nouns then we have احدا ينقضون احد الله they break you know they break the promises covenant of Allah احدا احدا يعهد اعهد احدا يعهد اعهد three verbs now three nouns عاهد معهود احد عاهد معهود احد all together احدا يعهد اعهد عاهد معهود احد then we have وهبا weak letter verb وهبا وهب لنا من لدنك رحمه we pray this regularly this dua وهبا he gave وهبا يهب هب وهب يهب هب three are the verbs now three nouns واهب موهوب وهب واهب موهوب وهب all together وهب يهب هب واهب موهوب وهب then we have وقع like about the qiyamah Allah say إذا وقعت الواقعة وقع means to occur occurrence وقع وقع يقع قع وقع يقع قع واقع موقع وقوع three nouns واقع موقع وقوع all together وقع يقع قع واقع موقوع وقوع then we have وعدا Allah said ألا إن وعد الله حق indeed promise of Allah is truth وعدا وعدا he promised وعدا يعد عد وعدا يعد عد three verbs and now three nouns واعد موعود وعد واعد موعود وعد all together وعد يعد عد واعد موعود وعد
please then all of you I think all of you the audience keep repeating with brother Abdul Rahim I would love to repeat but I have been shouting so I want to keep my energy reserved for the next part of the session otherwise I would have been repeating with brother Abdul Rahim so go ahead all of you should repeat with him please bismillah
yes.
continue
yes please then we have wajada is he found wajada ka dalan fahada wajada he found something good wajada yajidu jid wajada yajidu jid now three nouns wajid the one who finds the finder wajid maujood wujood واجد موجود وجود all together وجد يجد جد واجد موجود وجود then we have وصل ويقطعون ما أمر الله به أن يوصل to join وصل يصل سل وصل يصل سل واصل موصول وصول واصل موصول وصول all together وصل يصل صل واصل موصول وصول then we have ولد the best example from سورة الإخلاص لم يلد ولم يولد neither he begets nor begotten ولد ولد يلد لد ولد يلد لد three verbs now three nouns والد مولود ولادة والد مولود ولادة والد is father right and this is والدة mother so today we can tell our parents this is mom this is your TPI والدة والد والدة all together والدة يلد لد والد مولود ولادة the last one وقع like وقنا عذاب النار daily we say this وقنا عذاب النار وقع to save to protect وقع يقي تي in this imperative this order form تي we have only one single letter because واو قاف يا two weak letters they can't bear the burden they do get dropped okay the only the middle one تي تينا وقينا عذاب النار in the دعاء so وقع يقي تي three verbs three nouns واقين موقين وقاية واقين موقين وقاية all together وقع يقي تي واقين
موقين وقاية
واقين موقين وقاية
MashaAllah. I think that's it. Jazakallah khair, Brother Abdul Rahim. I think we are at the end. And as Brother Abdul Rahim said, yaqi, waqina adab al-nar, waqa yaqi. So you drop ya and the weak letter runs away. So what you are left with is qi. So now you know why qi, just one word, one letter means save. Save us. Qi na. Okay. So, mashallah, weak letter runs away whenever there is order. So, there is no more tolerance of, he cannot tolerate the order. It's too weak. وَقِنَا عَذَابَ النَّارِ So, now we go to the Kahoot now. And inshallah, be ready. So, any questions, please?
Yes, doctor.
Till I go to the Kahoot.
إِن كُنْتُمْ صَادِقِينَ What is the meaning?
They're asking, you are truthful. You are
truthful.
Why not if you were truthful? That was a question. Is it right?
Yes.
Well, I think this is Nahavi question. And inshallah, you will learn more at level 5. But as of now, please take it as it is.
Yeah.
Because of in, the in effect is there. In is a conditional sentence. And we have things like that in conditional sentences. Yes, go ahead. Next.
What is the TPI of Ruji'a?
Ruji'a. This is Raja'a. He returned. Okay, Raja'a. Ruji'a. Just keep your hand in the passive receiving position. Like Nasara, he helped. Nusira, he was helped. Sami'a, he heard. Sumi'a, he was heard. Okay. Ja'ala, he made. Ju'ila, he was made. Okay. Walada, he gave birth. Wulida, he was given birth. And so on. So, wulida, wulidu, wulita, wulitu, wulitu, wulidna, and so on.
In turjaun, how do we know it is passive voice? Please explain.
Okay, that's a very interesting question. How do we know that it is passive voice? Well, first of all, we will have to do kind of exercises on, by the way, note down the Kahoot 844809. First of all, we have to... we'll tell you the passive forms after a while. And in fourth course, we give you a lot of exercises. But as of now, this is, for example, you know, fa'ala, fa'alu, fa'alda, fa'aldu, fa'aldu, fa'alna. So fu'ila, fu'i, u'i, u'i in the past tense will make it passive. And here it will start with u, and there will be no e there. For example, yadribun, yudrabun. So it starts with U and there is no E sound in this one. That's the only clue at this point. it starts with you, like yuf'alu, yuf'alun, tuf'alu, uf'alu, tuf'aluna, nuf'alu. Okay, yuf'alu, yuf'alun, tuf'alu, uf'alu, tuf'aluna, nuf'alu. So that's the clue, and there is no passive active voice for this fa'il, you know, amr and nahi. So only these six and these six will have passive forms. All right, so those are the only clues that we have. Any other short question?
One question, but WhatsApp group related. Where is this table in UK website PowerPoint for grammar? So I think this is WhatsApp related.
Okay, it is there. The table of it's there in the textbook that we have displayed. All right, so now let us go to the question. First question is, three noun keys of wajada. Noun keys means fa'il, maf'ul, fa'il. So wajada, yajidu, jid. What is this one? Okay. Is it wajid, mawjud, jid? Wajada, yajidu, jid. Wajid, mawjud, wujud. Or wajada, yajidu, wujud. It is wajid, mawjud, wujud. This is the right answer. Okay. Wajid, fa'il, maf'ul, ful. So wajid, mawjud, these were correct. These are nouns, but jid is verb. Jid is verb. It is wujud. It is not jid, wujud. Okay. So you were tricked there. Hopefully now you realize that you were in a trap. Next one. Three verb keys of wasala. Is it wasala yasilu sil, wasala yasilu wasil, wasala, sorry, wasil mausul wusul, wasala yasilu mausul. I have this mic in front of me, so I have to do like that, blocking my screen vision. Okay, verb keys are wasala yasilu sil. Okay, verb keys are wasala yasilu sil, mashallah. Multi-select, translate ya'maloon. That's very simple. You all do, they did, they do, they will do. Maybe the simplest question, just to wake you up and give you confidence. Ya'maloon, ya'maloon, they do or they will do. MashaAllah, because mudare has both present and future tense meanings. Translation of wajattum. Okay, wajada, wajadu, wajatta, wajattu, wajattum. Is it you all find, you all found, you all will find, he finds. Wajattum, you all found. It is Maadi. Wajattum, you all found. All right. Next one, translate into Arabic. You all testify, like from Shahada. You all testify. This one. Is it Yashadun, Yashadu, Tashadun, Ashadu? You all testify, tashhadun. Yashhadun means they testify. Yashhadun, they testify. Tashhadun, you testify. You all testify. Hal ya'idullahu al-mu'minina. Does Allah promise the believers? So you should say, yes, Allah promises the believers. So what will it be? Na'am wa'adallah, or ya'iduhumullah, or wa'adahumullah, or ya'idullahu al-mu'minin. I told you about third person, nothing changes except yes or no. So that's a big clue. Hal ya'idu Allahu al-mu'mineen. So na'am ya'idu Allahu al-mu'mineen. Yes, Allah promises the believers. Okay. So nothing changes except na'am. Hal sami'tum al-Quran? Did you all hear the Quran? Did you all hear the Quran? So you said, yes, we heard the Quran. Is it sami'tum or sami'na, nasma'u, asma'u? Naam sami'na. MashaAllah. Naam sami'na al-Qur'ana. Yes, we heard. Let's just do a little bit practice. Stum anna. Okay, you heard. Did you hear? Yes, we heard. Hal sami'tum? Answer me. Naam. Sami'na. Hal fatahtum?
Naam.
Fatahna. Hal nasartum?
Naam.
Nasarna. Hal darabtum? Naam. Darabna. Or ma darabna. Hal sami'tum?
Naam.
Sami'na. هل وهبتم؟
نعم
وهبنا. هل وعدتم؟
نعم
وعدنا. Okay. هل what is that؟ قلتم؟
نعم
قلنا. Okay. So تم will become نا. These are all ماضي. And present will be, you know, for example, هل تسمعون؟ You will be saying نسمع. هل تفعلون؟ نفعل. So answer me. هل تفعلون؟ نعم نفعل. So take that noon, ending noon, put it here and just for the clue. هل تفتحون؟
نعم
نفتح. هل تنصرون؟
نعم
ننصر. هل تضربون؟
نعم
نضرب or لا نضرب. Okay. هل تسمعون؟
نعم
نسمع. هل تهبون؟
نعم
نهب. هل تقولون؟
نعم
نقول. All right. So I hope you are getting stronger there. هل أنتم حامدون? Are you the one who prays? So you should say yes. We are the one who prays. Is it أنا حامد? هم حامدون? نحن حامدون? أنتم حامدون? نعم نحن حامدون or نعم أنتم حامدون. That's the real answer. So it is نعم نحن حامدون. Yes, we are those who praise. I'm asking أنتم, so it will be نحن. All right. وعملوا الصالحات. Translate. That is of course one question. And they did good deeds, they did good deeds, they do good deeds, they will do good deeds. Please remember, go according to the grammar here. وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ. According to the grammar here, not according to the overall translation of the verse. وَعَمِلُوا, they did. Okay, عَمِلُوا, and they did. In the translation of the verse, it may be, you know, except those who believe and do good deeds. That is according to the message. But amilu is fi'il madhi. They did. Wa hab lana. Translate. Give us, they give us, you give me, and give us. Be careful. It is not wahab is not one word. It is wahab. Wahaba yahabu hab. Okay. So that wahaba he gave. But here that wahab, no. Wa is and hab is give. Hab lana and give us. That's it. MashaAllah. We are within time. Then we are looking at the toppers now. Brother Hadi and Sister Asma, and we have Dr. Muhammad Ismail, and then we have Sister Maryam and Brother Sayyid. And let's go for the others also, and we will give you 10 minutes of time for interaction questions. So start typing your questions. We'll give first preference to questions, and if we have time, then we will give the mic to some people. So here are the toppers. And I will keep displaying toppers. So questions, please.
Till now, no question, doctor. So you can
now go. No question. So we'll give answers for raising hands and asking questions live. So please give them chance to ask live.
Yeah, dear students, you can raise the hand. We will just unmute you.
And those of you who don't want to listen to question answer, they can leave the class.
Doctor, before that, I request you to announce for the level 3, which is going to start in the last week of August. So can you just make an announcement?
Yeah, that, please, you know, don't go away. The second course was so easy. The third course will be easier. We will have mazid fee, which is laziz fee, will be tasty, and you will have access to almost 90% of all the combinations that you can do of the verbs. And mazid fee occurs once in every line of the Quran, and we'll just study another 5 pages. So it's a very simple course. And you know what? Subhanallah, it's a wonderful option you have been doing. So don't skip until you finish the Quran. At least these 5 courses will be there. So all of you are strongly encouraged to register.
We yes. have Sister Rafia Ahmed.
Go ahead.
Sister Rafia, you can just unmute your mic.
Yeah, she's unmuted. Go ahead and
speak. Please, go ahead.
Can you hear me?
Yes, we can.
Yes. I had this question. I joined a little late, sorry. Tarja'un, you were showing the signs and I just made the hand signs, but I didn't quite catch all of it. If you could kindly go over it.
Okay. Let me just increase the sound here. Okay. Actually, turja'un is a passive voice word. Turja'un. Okay. Tarji'un, you return. Turja'un, you are returned. Okay. Like tansurun, you help. Tunsarun, you are helped. Or tadribun, you hit. Tudrabun, you are hit. Okay. So it's a passive voice. You will learn more about passive voice.
Oh, okay. Yeah, I was just getting. So there was one more thing that you were saying somewhere in the verse. Lakum, I think you said, and you were giving an example of, you know, that Allah has been so.